Hello students, in our last class we have seen what are the changes taking place during the age of adolescence. Yes children, so we have discussed earlier that adolescence is the age between the childhood and adulthood, that is from 10 to 19 years it is the age of adolescence, where there are number of changes taking place in the physical appearance and also inside the body of an adolescent girl or boy. We have seen different sexual characteristics, secondary sexual characteristics are also taking place. The changes are taking place biologically inside the girl and a boy. So this is the reproductive phase of the adolescent girls and boys, where they develop the secondary sexual characters. In boys, they are ready to produce the sperms from the testes, and girls, adolescent girls, reach their menarche stage, that is they undergo the ovaries from the ovum, the ova from the ovaries will be released and they start maturing. So this is the age they develop different sexual characters, hence it is called as the reproductive phase in their life. So reproduction is the process of different different basic process taking place in the bodies of the organisms. So this reproduction is also one of the processes like digestion, excretion, respiration. So reproduction is the process of production of the or continuation of the generation. So at this age, the girl is able to, after reaching her maturity biologically, she is able to bear the child. At this age, they are ready to produce the ovum. After the fertilization of the ovum, they can produce a child. So, as we have seen in the earlier lesson, that the male is producing the gamete, male gamete is a sperm, and the female gamete, it is ovum, which undergoes fusion, fertilization, internal fertilization takes place to produce the zygote. Zygote, after a number of divisions, it changes into embryo. An embryo, it forms after undergoing a changes, it is the fetus which is planted in the uterus of the female. So after completing the 9 months, that is the gestation period or pregnancy period in the girls, they are going to produce a baby, boy or girl. So like this, it starts at the age of adolescence, but in some cases we'll see some of the child, they are getting married at an early age, that is before they reach an age of 18 years. As they are getting ready, that is reproductive phase in their life may be entering in the adolescence age, that is from 10 to 19 years, but physically and mentally they are not ready to bear a child. Actually they are child, they cannot produce a child again. So child marriages should not be done, even though they have reached the reproductive phase in their life. They should be very healthy and confident enough physically, mentally, they should be very strong, then only they can bear a child. And education is also very important part in their life also. So till the age of 14 or 15 years, they should have the basic education in their lives, whether it may be a girl or a boy, they should be educated. Then only they will know what are the good and bad which they are going to face in their lives. So this is the age where they feel insecure, but teachers and parents should support them in every step they are going to take. So even the adolescent girls and boys should also listen to their elders, whether it may be teachers, parents or elder sister or brother, they should listen to their words, because with lot of experience they are going to tell all those things. They should, this is the age where they get into the bad habits. Mainly they feel that their friends are very good enough to tell all those things. But I tell you children, this is the age where it is a period or a age where it is a age of confusion, or it is a transition phase where you are entering from the childhood into the adolescence age. So this is a stage where you should be very mentally, physically and socially you should be very freely moving, so that you should be very judging in reaching the friends. That is, you should be very careful in making the friendships. Mostly they are attracted to the girls are attracted towards the boys, and boys are attracted towards the girls at this age. But I tell you children, this is not the age. It is only you should concentrate on your education, and you should concentrate on your physical build-up or healthy things. This is the most important thing. And you should listen to your parents and respect the teachers, which are the very helpful, which are very helpful persons in your life for judging your life, not your friends. Yes, right children? I hope you understand my internal feeling that this is the age everybody has to cross in their life. So this is the age you should take care of everything, whatever the food you are eating and the physical exercise. You should eat balanced diet, as you have discussed in the earlier session, that it is the age where increased growth height is taking place and reproductive organs are also getting matured in your body. So you should eat healthy food and do physical exercise also. You should be very clean hygienically, personal hygiene. You should maintain your personal hygiene so that you will avoid so many infections and diseases. Now, we will discuss about the hormones now. So, at this age, during this reproductive phase, even the hormones related to the reproductive system are also getting mature. So, we will see what are the different hormones which are affected or which are changing in this adolescent age. So here we'll discuss about the hormones. So what are these hormones, from where they are produced? Here in our body there are certain glands which does not have ducts. They are the endocrine glands. They does not have ducts, hence they are known as ductless glands. They secrete some of the chemical substances known as hormones. These hormones are released directly into the blood. So some of the hormones we will discuss now children. See, first one is testis. This is a gland. Testis is a gland which is releasing the hormone testosterone. So this testosterone is going to release the sperms from the boys, adolescent boys, and it helps in the testosterone. It also helps in the development of the secondary sexual characters in the males, that is adolescent boys. It starts at the age of adolescence. Next, second one is ovaries. Ovaries, the glands where it produces two different hormones, estrogen and progesterone. This helps in the release of ovum and attainment of a maturation in girls, adolescent girls, and embryo, development of the embryo implantation, and secondary sexual characters in females. Yes, children, estrogen and progesterone. And also helps in the secretion of milk in the mammary glands of the adolescent girls. Next, pituitary. It is called as a master gland where it controls other hormones also, like growth hormone, which helps in the growth, and follicle stimulating hormone. It stimulates the formation of ovum in case of adolescent girls and formation of sperms in the adolescent boys. Next one is a luteinizing hormone. It stimulates the egg to bust out from the follicle and flow into the fallopian tubes. So these are the hormones from the pituitary gland. And next one is the adrenal gland. Adrenal gland will produce the adrenaline. So this adrenaline hormone, it controls the emotions. So mostly this is the age where the adolescent girls and boys, they react. So it is also known as flight and fight hormone. This adrenaline is also known as the flight and fight hormone. So these are the different hormones. They are produced and influence the adolescent girls and boys. So as told by the psychiatrist Stanley Hall, that adolescent age is the age of stress and strain. So it is the age of stress and strain. If you take the proper guidance of the parents and teachers and your well-wishers, you can lead a happy life ahead. Okay.